like it.
Fernando came.
Thank you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome everyone to San Jose, and also those who are home. My apologies, last Sunday, the online sound system was broken, and so the word is issued, and we are trying to fix it. Here at Wesley, we also essential function by creating a safe environment where all the environment, law, accepted value, and of course, what they are, potential practices such as empathy, compassion, generosity, hospitality, and compassion. If you are on Zoom, please raise your hand and your name and name of those who are listening to worship.
Thank you.
Okay.
morning. I'm just here to remind you all, whoever wants to buy a t-shirt, send a t-shirt for the child, or for yourself, and maybe adult sizes as well. It says in the bulletin here, students of Western Church will be designed, they are designed, and their families from that t-shirt, which will be yellow, and it's called the names, the whole side of the
foundation make us also aware that we cannot pray that and acknowledge your presence without being with us or your other children of this world. Instead, with us today, help us to embrace them in our son, the broken and the lost, the oppressed and powerless, even our enemies, the suffering and the grief, the longing and the depressed. Gracious God, we pray from all ourselves to your power and your love, for we deeply need to trust your vision to this world. We pray for people in wherever is praying, amen. Food, clean water, shelter, healthcare, freedom, and human rights. God of compassion, we need your time with us on our life journeys. Be with each of us when we walk through different paths, especially grief, fear, all that, all fear, and those who are in our prayers, and all our enemies, and those who remain in our hearts now. Keep them in your presence, and be powerful with your healing and power. Holy God, in this evening, in the season of Lent, we pray that we become more full of yours. Make us to listen to your call to each of us. Hear our prayers this day, for we offer them in the name of our Christ Jesus, who called us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of God. Receive these offerings and transform them into your grace, that we might discover the goodness of the life to which you call us. We pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
How pleased to see you.
Thank you.
disagreement, this ordinance, or letter of call, Romans chapter 8, verses 8 to 11. I read from the Revised Standard Version. To set the mind on the flesh is death, but to set the mind on the spirit is life and peace. For this reason, the mind that is set on the flesh is hostile to God, and does not submit to God's law. Indeed, it cannot, and those who are in the flesh cannot please God. But you are not in the flesh, you are in the spirit, since the Spirit of God dwells in you. Anyone who does not have the Spirit of Christ does not belong to him. But if Christ is in you, then the body is dead because of sin, but the Spirit is life because of righteousness. If the Spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, he who raised Christ Jesus from the dead will give life to your mortal bodies also through his Spirit that dwells in you. Please stand in the body of the Spirit of gospel reading. The gospel reading is selected verses from chapter 11 of the gospel according to John. Now a certain man was ill, Lazarus of Bethany, the village of Mary and her sister Martha. Mary was the one who anointed the Lord with perfume and wiped his feet with her hair. Her brother Lazarus was ill. So the sisters sent a message to Jesus, "Lord, he whom you love is ill." But when Jesus heard it, he said, "This illness does not lead to death, rather it is for God's glory, so that the Son of God may be glorified through it." Accordingly, though, Jesus loved Martha and her sister and Lazarus. After having heard that Lazarus was ill, he stayed 2 days longer in the place where he was. When Jesus arrived, he found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb for 4 days. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went and met him while Mary stayed at home. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now I know that God will give you whatever you ask of him." Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise again." Martha said to him, "I know that he will rise again in resurrection on the last day." Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. Everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Messiah, Son of God, the one coming into the world." When Mary came where Jesus was and saw him, she knelt at his feet and said to him, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." When Jesus saw her weeping, and the Jews who came to her also weeping, he was greatly disturbed in spirit and deeply moved. He said, "Where have you laid him?" They said to him, "Lord, come and see." Jesus reacted. Then Jesus again, great in his spirit, came to the tomb. It was a cave, and the stone was lying against it. Jesus said, "Take away the stone." Martha and sister of the dead man said to him, "Lord, I'm afraid of the stench, because he has been dead for days." Jesus said to her, "Did I not tell you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God?" So they took away the stone. Jesus looked upward and said, "Father, I thank you for having heard me. I knew that you always hear me. I have said this for the sake of the crowds standing here, so that they may believe that you sent me." When he had said this, he cried with a loud voice, "Lazarus, come out!" The dead man came out, his hands and feet covered with strips of cloth, and his face wrapped in a cloth. Jesus said to them, "I'm coming, let him go." Many of the Jews, therefore, who had come here and had seen what Jesus did, believed in him. This is word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus.
Death has been our watchdog. So Christ has been Lord of the dead. He was prepared and who fights this morning. He prayed in death and he did pray in the sea. O Jesus, you are the Lord of the dead. That was a natural disaster. Pain goes by five houses. Never have I seen our seeds and hearts. Wrecking life of hope, joy, hopes, continue work of passion and faith in prayer outside. Drama, baby, yen, Syria, and then after the war. The least we have all won. And we have made that for our lords. Our peace could be stopped. But it shows where we are a part of our realities. That works in which Jesus is us as he moves toward his suffering and death. He was aware of the one that some people were seeking to storm. According to John, the race of Lazarus is the firework of Jesus that causes the authorities of the arrest and execution. Thus, this story sets the stage for the passion of Jesus as well as his resurrection. Martha now sent the message to Jesus, "Lord, he who we love is here." Jesus responded that the illness is not to death, but for the glory of God. As John to a comment, Jesus loved Martha and her sister and Lazarus. No other passage in the New Testament speaks so clearly of Jesus' love. Despite his love, Jesus waited 2 days before setting out on the journey. Martha and Mary both could tell Jesus how upset they were with him, that he did not show up when they said, they expected that Jesus would have done something to prevent their Lazarus' death if only he had come when he was called. The problem was not that Jesus was not able. The problem was that Jesus had not cared enough to be dead when they were needed. Despite their questions, Jesus had let your brother die. Be honest. Is this not the feeling we have when things come against us, despite the fact that we have prayed? Despite the fact we have thought we were going the extra mile? Despite that we see ourselves as good? Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." When Jesus tries to comfort her by saying, "He will live again," she fails to understand. Ci sono dire che la nostra sede, dati Paris, Barna expressed faith in the common Jewish feeling of the heart in the general direction of the death of the next day. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me will be alive with me, and everyone who believes and believes in me will be never die. These words are spoken at most memorial and funeral services. That is to say, in me, the promise of resurrection and eternal life is a present reality. Then he asked Mark, do you believe this? Somewhat strangely, Mark's answer had no direct connection with resurrection. She confessed to Jesus the similar to Peter's confession. Yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Messiah, the Son of God, the one coming to the world. The story that shifted to the meaning of Mary and Jesus. Mary spoke the very same words as Martha did. Notice that, despite all the confidence that both sisters had in Jesus and his power to have any situation with death, when it came to the moment of truth that Lazarus told, the reality of death hit everyone's heart. When Jesus saw Mary weeping and the sorrow of those who came in front, he was greatly disturbed in spirit and deeply moved. In the Greek text, the expression has more implication of anger and sorrow. It expresses Jesus' anger and power of death and sorrow of his relatives. Then Jesus wept. God incarnated feels the pain of loss and weeps with Mary and Martha and all of Lazarus' friends. Once again, Jesus greatly disturbed the cause of the world. He asked, take away the stone. But the point has been sharpened. How bad that is. Martha says, Lord, already there is a stench because he has been dead for days. Confronted with the harsh reality of death, all Martha's previous high sound trust in Jesus and his resurrection are painful. When you are dead, you are dead. That's it. Jesus Christ in a loud voice, Lazarus, come out. But then he emerged, and Jesus said, by the hand that he called. The ways of Lazarus is not all that his sisters and friends think he will be. Because he made many people to believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the chief priests decide to kill Jesus and Lazarus. By life, death can be postponed. Lazarus got a reprieve to the delights of his sisters and friends, but he was still mortal, and Lazarus was still going to have to die again. The race of Lazarus is a common moment in the history of Jesus. This was seen in the high point of his mission news, but it is like death. There is more to all. The real crisis is when Jesus is on a cross, choosing to suffer and die with sinners like you in order to destroy your power of sin, death, He says, be clear on that, that life is made wrong. When he chooses to lay down his life on the cross and then raises from the dead, with a body that shows the promise of God. Blessings. We emerges from the grace, the body of reverence with which he was buried, we die for the day. But Jesus, whose burial cross are left in the tomb, is the people of God who we never know. Jesus is the resurrection and the life. He alone is able to do something much more than our world. He is able to become a life that falls on God forever. When we know that our dear ones that have been born again or the world connects with holy parents, when we know our dear ones that died trusting Christ, promise of everlasting life, then we know that they will eventually overcome by the fall when we are united with those that have died in Christ Jesus. Therefore, in moments all critical things, you are not in the flesh, you are in the Spirit, since the Spirit of God dwells in you. If the Spirit of God, who raised Jesus from the dead, dwells in you, God, who raised Christ from the dead, will give life to you of the bodies also, with us Spirit that dwells in you. Yet, death of our dear ones hurt and transform the rest of our lives. We do not want to live without the but the longer we live, the more wise we will save. And those death of new ones always hurt, even when we are certain that they are alive forever with Christ and that we shall see them. If so, what place has he given us? We are not asked not to grieve, but only not to despair. Because the one in whom we believe is our refuge, because he is our life. Lent is a time of preparation for Easter. We can never know the full impact of the resurrection unless we are honest with those times that we have felt no joy. That is not related to what happens to us in life is false joy. Only when we are honest with our hurts and fears can we know the full impact of the truth that God is to us. We have more than the loss of some of those we love. We will all have times of sorrow. But being honest with where we are will open our hearts and minds to the wonderfulness of this. When we are honest in our lives, we are overwhelmed, pressed down, poor love, poor of heart, can we live again? Can we see beyond what is in our control? Lazarus embodies all of us, you and me. We are being called to a new life, a new day, even when the situation seems hopeless. The power of Jesus pulls us out where we are buried in our fears, our pain, our grief, our wounds, life's precious. Take away the storm. We move for the local divine preference when we experience the power of Christ in our lives. This is what Jesus wants for each one of us. To each one of us, he says, take away the soul. Come on. I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And anyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this? What is the answer? Please let the body of the Spirit to see because it is body united that is in the blood of Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
and speak words of life. May God raise you up and guide you. May Christ Jesus dwell in you in righteousness. May the Holy Spirit be the light in your every breath. The love of God, the grace of Christ, and guidance of the Holy Spirit be with you now and always.